on a Wednesday, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
And I'm Sean.
Try it again. It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
No, quiet, just for me.
Quiet. It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
And on this week's show, first of all, we've got the prize we'll be announcing to get your next DVD, Magic and Madness.
We will. We've done the prize draw, and one of you won.
One of you did win. Thank you very much to everybody that shared the video. And if you share the video this time, you could have an opportunity to win Sans Mind's Cupid.
You could do.
Which I actually went out and tried at the weekend, actually did it at the wedding, and the reaction was incredible.
Did you hurt anybody with the arrow?
I didn't. I managed to hit the heart perfectly. The heart was impaled with the bride and groom's initials on there. It really was a beautiful thing. It was a great moment of magic, actually. So you'll have a chance to win Sans Mind's Cupid if you share this video right now, anywhere, whether it be in a magic group or on your own Facebook wall. First of all, this week we've got a product, it's fair to say, there's been a lot of buzz about this product.
There has been a serious amount of buzz about this product. And if you don't know what it is, something was going on there. I'm not sure I want to know what it was, but either David or Blimey would do something strange. Anyway, what happens is it's Michael Amar and Dirk Lysander.
Dirk Lysander.
And you make a wine glass float. And it, not only can you does it float, it lands on the palm of the spectator as well, and it's something that can be used either close up or on stage.
Let's talk about what you get with it, first of all, shall we?
What you get with it is, you're all familiar with the zombie ball routine, so we can't say the exact gimmick, but it's a little bit more specialised than
that. It's fair to say it's not that.
It's not that, but ish. But it is a similar type of gimmick.
It's very good because it actually does pick up a wine glass.
Picks up a wine glass. And easily with picks this up a wine glass.
Yeah, we've tried it in the office, not with liquid in there or anything like that. It floats the glass very, very nicely. And by far, the strongest part of this routine is when the glass lands on the hands of the spectator at the end. When Dirk does it, and we'll get to this point in a moment, it looks very, very magical indeed. As when we see him do his floating table. You see it at the magic conventions, and you see him do the floating table, and you just think, that's floating. That is floating.
But we'd only had it out of the box half an hour.
Yeah.
And then the boiler man came to fix the boiler. Because it's a bit cold here in Rugby. And he said, isn't that like the trick that I do for my kids at home where I put the spoon behind the tea towel and chase them around the kitchen? And do you know what? There's two things here. He's kind of got a point, because that visual where you've got a cloth held by either hands and there's something moving forward does look like that trick.
Yeah. There are things addressed in the video.
The flip side to that is if you watch an expertly executed zombie ball routine, or if you watch somebody who's a master at this, like Dirk Lysander doing his floating table or floating other things, then it really does look like magic.
So, I think a lot of people could get this and be fooled into thinking, this is easy.
Yeah.
I could do it. And actually, to make it look effortless, to make it look like a thing of beauty, like this wine glass is actually floating and not like the bread roll behind the napkin trick, then, like Dirk points out in the downloadable instructions, as well as the instructions that you get in the box with the gimmick, you do need to spend some time making sure that your hands are moving freely and independently around this glass at the same time that the glass has got a mind of its own and floating up and down by itself. And the best bit of the routine for me is when it lands on the spectator's hands and you take the cloth away. With a little bit more work, which is discussed on the DVD, I should say downloadable instructions, you can actually end up completely clean. When that cloth is dropped down, you could then raise it up straight away and give them that cloth to be examined if you wanted to.
Or produce a bottle of wine from behind
it. Or produce a bottle of wine if you wanted to at the same time. You'd need another gimmick for that, to be fair. I don't know where you get
one. I've got a way of doing it.
Yeah, I bet you have. So, all in all, is this something you will perform, Sean Hayden?
It's not going to go into my set.
No.
It's not my style of thing, unfortunately, but it is very well made.
You've got to admit, we looked at it. The gimmick is unique. It's very well made. You kind of look at it and think, oh, is that it? But what you do with it and how well a certain part of the gimmick has been made, you can't deny it's very, very clever.
Absolutely.
It works. it accomplishes the effect. The description and the explanation that you get on the downloadable instructions, that's not going to disappoint you. It's Michael Amar and it is Dirtless Sander. They know what they're talking about. But at the same time, you've got to bear in mind, please bear in mind, that you need to be a great performer, or you need to spend time to make this look good. And it doesn't really fit my style. I think I wouldn't do the effect justice. I think I would end up reducing it to a little piece of sort of satirical comedy or something I performed
it. The only way I would perform this, which is why I'm not going to buy it, so nobody panic.
Yeah.
The only way I would perform this would be to make it float and then do the joke and drop the cloth.
Yeah, which you're not going to do
Do not do that. It's too good for that.
A lot of comedy magicians do that with Zombie Ball. I've seen that quite a few times at magic conventions. I think a lot of people do know the secret of the zombie, even lay people as well, which is a shame.
But because of the shape of the thing, this which we're talking about Tommy Wonder with his birdcage.
Yeah.
Wait, which is similar.
Yeah, they've changed the shape of the gimmick, and it's very similar to the Tommy Wonder birdcage. And one of the great things about that is the fact that you can have this hands not moving at all,
and yet the thing
is moving up and down underneath the
cloth. Or your hands go up and the thing's going down, and it's going the opposite way to your hands.
Yeah, it's moving independently to your hands, which makes it very deceptive. That is employed here. I just don't think I can do it justice. But when it's done well, it is a beautiful piece of magic. So it's like, don't know what to say, but I'm giving it 78%.
Yeah, I'm going to give this one 75%.
It's very nice. It's hard to judge, isn't it? Because it does look good when he does it. Yes. Put some clips on the screen.
Like Reggie and Bowling. Hard to judge.
Yeah, especially with that single.
Terrible.
Next up, we've got an effect called Rise by Sean Scott. And this is an effect that we've seen on TV, actually, a few times.
Quite a few times. I'm forgetting the guy's name, but I've seen it on an American Street Magic special. I've seen Dynamo do it on television. Yeah. And has Justin Flom done it? I can't remember.
I don't know if Justin's done it. I've not seen that clip online or anywhere like that. But I'm going to say up front, I didn't think this was going to be very good. And I got the gimmick out. And I was like, okay, this is pretty good. In fact, I'm going to go on record right now and say this is one of the best produced gimmicks, if not the best produced gimmick, I've seen in all my time on the Wizard product review.
Brilliant.
I think this bit of kit that you get in this box, and although it's got a box, got some other bits in there, you do get a very rather nice tube as well as some other bits inside there. But the gimmick itself... Well, let's talk about it. Most people know the effect. Talk about the effect first.
Well, the effect is basically you get a crushed can. So a kind of Red Bull that's been crushed down.
Yeah.
Okay, you put it on
ready
the floor.
Ready to recycle.
Ready to recycle. You put it on the floor, you stamp on it, and then when you lift your foot up from underneath your foot, the squashed can just comes back whole again and sealed. And not only that, it is a normal can that can then be handed out for examination for them to drink or whatever. There's a bit of a signed-ish version on there which advertises, which I'm not a fan of.
I think they just put that on there for magicians.
Yeah,
it can be signed.
And the method for doing it is a bit of a disappointment for me, if I'm honest.
Yeah.
But don't let that take away from the effect, because there's ways of making it appear to be using the same can all the time,
which you
don't need a sign method. For example, if somebody, you know, had a can of Budweiser, you're always drinking Bud at a bar, you could kind of wangle it, you could engineer the situation at the gig to make it look as if it was an impromptu trick.
Yeah, because...
And if you're doing it, and if people really do think it's impromptu, there's no need to have the can signed.
Yeah, it does look great the moment he stamps down and he lifts up, and it's almost like you see that can pop up. We'd be lying if we said there's not angle restrictions, but it is just a restriction. And the more we did play around with it, we didn't want to set it up today, but we got some cans of Red Bull and had a little bit of a play and checked that the gimmick actually worked. But your angle is restricted, but if your audience is out there watching, which they normally are, to be fair, in the real world.
I've got a use for this, and my use is straight after, when I do my close-up magic, I put everybody in a certain position when I'm going to do my card in mouth routine.
Yeah.
And when they're in that position, that is the perfect position for me to do that.
Yeah.
And if you're doing card in mouth, basically close up, similar angles will work with this.
Yeah, the gimmick, I thought I knew how it was done anyway when I watched the video. I was like, right, I know what's going on here. This is going to be some lame thing. It's going to be a bag and a bit of string or something like that. Actually, it's not. It's
brilliant.
A very, very high-tech kind of gimmick that works, and you have to build this into your costume, let's say, and the costuming that you choose for your gig, you're going to need to think about that. You can't use skinny jeans, for example, or anything like that. You might need to compromise on your style slightly.
But if you're working
But if you're working on a suit...
It'll work with these, won't it?
Normal suit trousers.
Yeah, normal suit trousers, it's going to be fine.
You'll be absolutely fine. The visual is fantastic.
Phenomenal.
Absolutely fantastic. And you reckon you're going to try this, actually?
I'm definitely going to try this at a gig, you know, because it's that extra thing. I always like to think you should do more than what the customers expect. And so if you've been hired to go around and do card tricks, if that's what the customer thinks, I think you should finish after each bit like that by doing something that's really going to blow their mind, that they're going to remember and talk about. And this, I really think, is one of their moments.
Do you think even though it's big, even though it's incredible, it could be perceived as almost like a throwaway thing to do because of the nature of the trick? You're just going like
that. It is a throwaway thing to do, but it's the impact that it has. You present it as if it's going to be a throwaway thing. So you've done your really technical card magic that you've been hired for, and then you go, hey, let me just show you something. Give me that can.
I can't imagine if you got people to a stage where they're only like half watching it, and they're like, you go, can I have that? Yeah, just put this, I'll try something in. You walk around it, so they see you walk around, they see you and everything else on all sides. You go, just watch that. And actually,
they're gonna
if you've got
out.
Somebody to video it and then share it afterwards at the event, and you gave it to the person, you know, videoing it, then in a way you're actually using street magic yourself, aren't you? Come
well, on, you know what? If you're doing weddings and there's a videographer at the wedding, this is the type of thing that you could even take the videographer to one side and go, hey, can I do something for the bride and groom's video? Because you know, the hard thing is with that, you can't do anything long for those types of videos.
No,
it's something that lasts 3 seconds, and if they just see the crushed can on the floor, and you go, crush the can, it's back up again,
and then
bam.
You cheers, open it and cheers, yeah.
You don't even need to do that, it's just bam, and then you've got your you can't get a better treat than that.
I would do this. Like this. I am going to get one of these. I'm going to get it for, you know, I keep planning it, you know, I've got to get a better magic showreel all the time. I think everybody's constantly evolving their showreels, and I think it's important to have little bits of magic in between, as well as the stuff with you interacting with spectators.
He's just turned around and farted on me.
Really?
Yeah, you smelly doggy.
He genuinely did that.
Yeah.
Maybe he picked it up on the camera, I don't know. But these are the good moments that you can have that look visual, look magical, and if you can show the odd moment of you even doing it at a gig, all the better.
Yeah.
But I think it's a great visual bit of magic. Definitely for street.
James Bond bit of kiff as well.
Yeah, definitely for TV, definitely for social media. I don't know whether I'll perform it live. I believe that you would, because I've seen some of the things that you prepare before your gigs. I don't mind preparing effects like refraction and that kind of thing. This I'm not sure of as much, but I do really like it. I'm giving it exactly 90%. Bearing in mind, when I first saw it, I really thought this was going to be in the 30s and absolutely pointless, rubbish, not work at all.
Well, do you know what? I'm going to break the rules of the Wizard product review, right? Because I'm going to go with you at 90%. However, that could move up to 99%. Because I'm going to take it, I'm going to prepare it, I'm going to do it at a gig.
You're going to try and share and that video.
I'm going to try and share the video, and I'm going to repost my mark on it.
If you can do that, that'd
so
be pretty good.
So it's 90%, because it's definitely going to be used by videos and stuff with me, especially when we're being filmed at corporate events and things. It's definitely getting used for that. It might get used every day in gigs at me, but I will let you know by the next Wizard product review. I can give you an update on that.
I do want to say as well that Sean more than proves that he's out there doing this live. It's got clips of him on Fremont Street performing it, and that's actually where B. Smith saw it the first time. I think B was the consultant for Dynamo at the time, which is probably how it ended up on the show.
Absolutely.
So if B. Smith's watching it, saying this is great, probably is.
That's a sneeze from Dave and a cough from me. Next up, we've got Sweet Penetration.
Love those kids.
By those kids at Sandsmise, those crazy kids.
They love thinking up titles like this for their effects, don't they?
They do.
So let me synopsize this effect for you. You're at an event or your coffee shop. You're hanging out with your friends, because that's what Chris suggests. Imagine hanging out with your friends at a coffee shop. It's kind of like it.
I say, Chris, stop talking. Show us a magic trick.
Yeah, and You get a coin signed, so probably a 5p or a penny in this country. Signed on both sides, genuinely signed by the spectator, not by you. And then you ask them, well, Herman on the DVD says, pick up the sugar packet, put it on my hand. They then take that sugar packet and they hold it at their fingertips. And you're stood quite a way back here and you throw the coin at the sugar packet, and at that moment there is a sweet penetration that occurs, because the coin seemingly goes straight into the packet, and immediately the spectator feels it. They can feel it in there. You show it both sides, you tear it, and then you tip it out onto their hand. Now, signed coin as well, naturally, and you leave them the packet. I don't think you need to worry about anything there. We both thought it's going to be rubbish. What do you think?
It wasn't rubbish. It was really good. And do you know what? There's a tiny bit of arts and crafts, but it's nothing too difficult.
No, it's nothing.
And I think I'm going to do this.
Yeah, I think I'll do it as well.
I didn't want to because of the name of it. And the fact it was a sugar packet, it was like, oh, this is going to be so bad. And it's not. It's actually really good. And do you know what? Think about it from a layperson's point of view.
If you can convince him, it's completely impromptu.
It's an impromptu effect. You're at a coffee shop, and a coin that goes into a packet of sugar, a signed coin, a packet of sugar that they're holding, that they've had in their hands the whole time.
Yeah.
That's, you know, it's so strong that.
Yeah.
It's like, imagine billing lemon, if you could get a banknote and throw it at the lemon, and then cut open the lemon and it was inside it, and it was a signed banknote, that'd be the perfect way of doing billing lemon, wouldn't it?
Yeah. I think if there's a criticism, sometimes, I think it happens a lot on Sandsmines DVDs as well. You get kids, especially, this is not like really a rant, it's just like an observation. I think a lot of kids these days that are interested in magic treat everything like a series of moves. And they just go, duh, check this, do that, rip open, done.
Yeah.
And actually they don't let the moments of magic sink in with spectators. They might do, you can feel it, right? Yeah, it's there. Okay, turn it open, there it is. But actually, they don't then engage with the spectator with their eyes, and you really need to actually engage with the spectator. And this isn't me talking, this is like a private lesson I had once with Tommy Wonder. And he said, at the moment of magic, you need to connect with the spectator, you and them. Don't just be looking at your props and actually doing it. And there are many moments in this where, first of all, it goes in, you can connect with them. They then feel that it's in there, and you connect with them again. And then when you tear it open, and you rip it open, you rip it, and then you connect with them again on this level. And you're actually selling yourself performing the magic, rather than you just being a tool to engineer this series of moves to create this magical moment. And if you apply that to this effect, and not just perform it in perhaps a throwaway way like it's done on the DVD, I believe that you've got a very, very strong moment of magic here.
Really strong piece of magic here.
Yeah, so there's not much more to say about it. It is the usual Sandsmines high quality production. You see a great live performance of it, just shot over the spectator's shoulder while Herman performs it. Herman is my favourite performer with Sandsmines, actually. You always see a great performance, you see him interacting with spectators, and you see it from start to finish, and at the end of it, I was left in no doubt that this is a great piece of magic that I want to use. I'm giving it 94%.
96% from me.
It's a great piece of magic. Congratulations to the team at Sandsmines. Knocked off a few marks, though, for the title. That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. We're not going to see you now until after Christmas. Thank you very much for watching the show. In fact, we showed this video, didn't we? We had a live link earlier.
Oh, we did have a live link.
We didn't think it was going to be great, but he's been quite kind of busy today. But we had a live link with Tim Peake on the International Space Station. We uploaded the DVD and we said, Tim, what do you think to the live performance? And he absolutely loved it. He gave us the thumbs up. The mic wasn't connected at the time, but he absolutely loved it. That's it from the Wizard Product Review this year. We'll see you in 2016.
Happy New Year. Don't forget,
if you share this video, you could win another Sans Minds release, the Fantastic Cupid, where you shoot a drawing of an arrow through a drawing of a heart, which could have the initials on, of the married couple. And it really is a memorable moment at a wedding. You could get that just for sharing. Happy Christmas.
And on the next show, you're going to reveal the worst release of 2015.
That was a concept, but are we actually going to do it now?
Yeah, because I just said it, and we can't refilm all that again.
We're going to do the worst trick of the year. It's a contender. It could be a contender. We'll see you next time on the Wizard Product Review. Happy Christmas to you and all your family. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great new year, guys. We'll see you in 2016. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
See you next time.